Oh. Oh, no. No. Hello. I've just been reading this book. I'm all of a doodah here. This is the most terrifying book I've ever read, yes, that I've ever written. You'll like it. Here it goes. Just a bit, mind you. You can't stand a long excerpt. Book one, The Long Night, The Beginning of Fear. The Time Lord was late. That's me. He was in trouble, and he'd been summoned to the Convocation of Oblivion to account for his actions. His august peers had gathered in a tall tower in a tall city to hear one of his tall stories. I like that bit. One of my stories it was. He's going to say he saved the universe again, huffed one to another, running a finger round his stiff collar. It's still where we left it, isn't it? His friend sneered. His friend had been a junior archivist for 3,000 years, I know. And in his experience, the universe continued much as it always had done. As if that's enough to stop him, hissed his friend, looking around at the crowd of collared lords all buzzing like angry wasps, woken from a nap. He always gets out of punishment by claiming to have snatched existence from the jaws of something or other, and yet the old archivist cast his old eyes up at the endless universe twinkling beyond the skies. And yet you don't see the stars going out, do you? Well, no doubt he claimed that was down to him, huffed a revered time lady. Ha, they all laughed. Little laughs, you know. As dry as burnt toast. I like that bit. We're in for a load of nonsense and braggadocio, she continued. She was put out that she'd been disturbed from her hobby of collecting dust. But I don't see him getting off so easily this time. These were the Time Lords of Gallifrey, the planet Gallifrey, and they were the most powerful creatures ever to exist. And they were waiting for the renegade to enter to confess his crimes. This time he'd gone too far, and they were going to put a stop to me, finally and forever. Ha ha. A hush fell over the room. The hush of a guillotine sensing the tumbril roll was near. A light stabbed down onto the stage, and a figure staggered into the beam, pinned there like a butterfly. A zero nun? Yes. A zero nun left her seat in the front row, striding up to the renegade, and she bowed to him with exaggerated courtesy. She said, "Have you anything to say for yourself?" "Hello and good evening," I said through gritted teeth. I was in trouble. As my brain adjusted to the pounding intensity of the bright light, I tried to work out what to say to them. My people had allowed me to go wandering in the universe, tinkering here and there, but occasionally they called me to account for my actions, normally when I overstepped the mark for some trifle or another. And she said, "Your recent actions endangered the entire universe," she informed me. Yes, something trivial like that, you know. They get excited about little things. The crowd seethed, and there was hunger to them. They were a bloodthirsty bunch. "Come now, have you nothing to say for yourself?" Her tone was coaxing, as if she was speaking to a sulking child. And there was the exact sound of 1,000 Time Lords leaning forwards on their benches, waiting, waiting for me to fail. "Well, Doctor," the nun pressed, "we are offering you a chance to account for your actions, surely." And she baited her trap with honey tones. "Surely, Doctor, you can't have meant to put us all in danger. We've allowed you a certain freedom, and you can't have intended to repay us with recklessness, can you now?" "Well," I began. I had to say something. Of course I did. It just wasn't what they were expecting. It may not be what you're expecting either, yeah. "You will allow me to speak freely?" "Of course." The zero nun smiled like a haunted tree.
Like a haunted tree?
Yes, like a haunted tree. "I'm sure you have an excellent explanation. After all, I'm sure I vouch for all of us when I say we'd hate to have wiped you from existence." "Well, thanks very much, Your Reverence." My audience nodded sanctimoniously, all the time sharpening their knives. "Come now, Doctor," the zero nun prompted. "Let's get to the bottom of this together." All right, I told her, but in order to do so, I need to teach you about fear.
Fear?
She blinked. That got her. So she blinked again. Yes, I addressed the entire chamber. You see, even the Time Lords are afraid of something, and tonight I'm going to show you what that is. Are you sitting comfortably? Huh? Are you sitting comfortably? Yes, of course you are. And I'm rather afraid that that is your problem. Oh, I do recommend it. Hold on. Yes, that's me, Tom Baker. Yeah. You'll love it. You'll absolutely love it. Buy two. Buy one for your granny. Goodbye. Goodbye. I hope we'll meet again. And if we don't, it's been marvelous.